Hello, 3D printing friends. So you're new to 3D printing? Just got a new 3D printer and you're looking for files to print? Well, you've come to the right video. I'll show you a couple of great places where you can find tons of free files to print, and we'll start right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Hey, congrats on getting that new 3D printer. At this point, you've probably already printed the 3 or 4 models that came on the printer's memory card or in its onboard storage, and now you're looking for more things to print. So I'm going to share some great places to get 3D models for your new printer. And the great news is that almost all of the files are free to download. So just a couple of quick notes before we get going. First, all these sites depend on the designers policing themselves and marking non-family-friendly designs as either adult or not safe for work. Unfortunately, not all designers do this, or they simply don't consider that kids are going to be browsing the site, or that parents are going to be browsing the site with kids nearby. So you may occasionally run across models that aren't kid-friendly, running the gamut from extended middle fingers to full-on nudity. Most of the sites will allow users to report such models, and that tends to take care of it. The sites are generally pretty good at keeping that content out of the reach of kids, but I wanted to give you a heads up so you won't be surprised if you see something like that. Second, many of these sites are operated by 3D printer manufacturers, but that doesn't mean you can only use those models with that manufacturer's printers. They've got hundreds of thousands of files available for free. As long as the file you want to print will fit within your printer's build volume, you can download it, prepare it in your favorite slicer, and print it on your printer. Third and last, if you're planning to launch a small business and sell the things you print, make sure that the license on the file you're printing allows commercial use. When you download a model file to print, there's almost always a license associated with it. So while a lot of models are completely free to download and some cost money, the license doesn't allow you to sell the prints. Sometimes you can buy a separate commercial license from the person who designed the model, which you should definitely do if you're going to sell prints, but other times, the models are personal use only. That means you can print them and give them away, but you can't print them and sell them. Okay, onward to the model sites. This is Printables. It's run by Prusa Research. It's got tons of free models sorted into categories for easy browsing. Or you can use the search feature if you're looking for something specific. You can sort by trending, new, most downloads, most makes, most likes, highest rating, or random. There's a separate store tab for paid models, and Printables also features clubs. Clubs are monthly subscriptions that offer a way to support the creators whose models you like and get access to club-only models. Some club membership levels include a commercial license, so you're allowed to sell prints of the models for as long as you're at that membership level. There's a community tab where you can follow designers and see what they've been up to. Printables has a reward system, which they call Prusa meters. These can be exchanged for spools of filament at a rate of 350 Prusa meters per spool. You can earn Prusa meters for doing things like completing your profile on the site, publishing a model, creating a collection of models, or uploading a make of someone else's model. A make is just a picture of your print, and you can get up to 100 Prusa meters a month just by doing that. And Printables frequently holds design contests with Prusa meters as prizes and occasionally actual 3D printers as well. You'll need to create an account on the site if you want to upload makes or models or earn Prusa meter points, but that's optional if all you want to do is download models. Printables has over 800,000 models, and the layout of the main page encourages you to explore the different sections like featured models and clubs. Visit printables.com to start exploring. Next, let's head over to MakerWorld, run by Bamboo Lab. Like Printables, it's got tons of free models, all organized, categorized, and searchabilized. And the layout of the main page lets you scroll to infinity if you're looking for inspiration on something to print. There are design contests here as well, with Bamboo Lab gift cards as prizes, with the first prize awards usually in the $300 to $400 range. In addition to the model files and contests, there are links to user forums and the Maker Supply Store. The Maker Supply Store has lots of physical, non-printable parts that go along with parts you print yourself to build cool things. The non-printable parts are things like screws, springs, bearings, motors, and electronics, though sometimes they're something as simple as rubber feet. There are clock kits, marble run kits, model engine kits, 3D printable computer mice, all kinds of things. Not everything is for everybody, so while some of these may be of questionable utility to you, they may be exactly what someone else is looking for. One more thing that helps MakerWorld stand out from the other sites is the Maker Lab tab. This is where Bamboo Lab has some really cool tools to create models for you. You can use the Make My Statue tool that'll create a bust from a picture, or the Printmon Maker to create a Pokemon-style creature from a simple prompt. This is one I made and printed. There's a lithophane maker, a desk organizer designer, an image to keychain thing, a vase maker, sign maker, and a cool thing to make pixel puzzles like this one. They've also got some in the experimental stage and you can play with those too, though they may be a little rough around the edges. You don't need an account on the site to download models, but you will need one if you plan to upload models you've created, create collections of models, or click like on them, or post makes, or earn points. Yes, MakerWorld has a point system. Earn points for completing your profile, creating models with MakerLab, or rating other users' print profiles. Some of the MakerLab features cost credits, which you can get in exchange for points, and you can also cash them out for gift cards or discount coupons for model kits. Visit MakerWorld.com and check it out. Next up, Thingiverse. It's run by 3D printer manufacturer Ultimaker, the company that's also responsible for the Cura slicer. Thingiverse has been around for approximately ever, and when I first started out in 3D printing, it felt like Thingiverse was the only game in town for downloading models. Given how long it's been around, it should be no surprise that it has over 2.5 million models available for download. One of the first things you'll probably notice about Thingiverse is that it's partially ad-supported. So on every page of models, you get 20 actual models and 3 or 4 ads. The main page of the site lets you sort by the most popular models from the last 30 days, or the last 7 days, things popular this year, the most popular models of all time, models with the most makes, or the newest models uploaded to the site. Thingiverse doesn't have a point system, and you don't need an account to download files. But you will need an account if you want to click like on a model, post a make, or upload a model you designed. And they occasionally run contests, and it looks like they sometimes partner with other companies to provide a theme for the contest and for prizes. Thingiverse, of course, lets you search for things you're interested in, or you can explore categories like art, fashion, gadgets, hobby, household, tools, and so on. Visit Thingiverse.com to get started. Up next is Thangs. Like Things, but with a southern accent. Why? I don't know. Thangs is kind of a hybrid site. It's both a model repository and a search engine that reaches across multiple sites to help you find what you're looking for. Given the number of sites Thangs can search across, it's not uncommon to come up with literally a million results on a search. I did a search for Ender 3 and got 1.1 million results. While that can seem overwhelming, you can narrow it down by applying filters. Only want to see models hosted on Thangs? You can do that. Want to see results from Thingiverse and Printables at the same time? You can do that too. Similar to clubs on Printables, Thangs has memberships where you can get monthly subscriptions to designers to get access to members-only models. Some designers also sell models individually, so you can just buy the one you want if you don't want to spring for a full monthly subscription. A cool feature that's unique to Thangs is that you can upload a 3D model into the search feature in order to find other similar models. The search feature also lets you filter by free or paid models, so if you're just looking to download freebies, you can find them. Speaking of downloading, unlike the other sites we looked at, you will need a free account to be able to get files from Thangs. Like some of the other sites, Thangs lets you scroll to infinity if you just want to see what's there and see if something calls out to you, begging to be printed. Go and see the cool Thangs that await you at Thangs.com. So that's a quick rundown of where you can find free files for your new 3D printer. There are plenty more, but I wanted to keep this video relatively short. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this one, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.